Do you hear?
It's good news. Probably not.
Well, Anna got off. The judge dropped the charges.
Yes, I did hear. One of the nurses at the hospital had the TV on.
I figured that you know who might have told you.
Who?
Jake. Who else?
Forget about Jake.
What?
I don't understand. Welcome to the club.
Hey, he won the trial. I thought that was going to be great for both of you as well.
Well, point is, there is no both of us anymore.
What happened? I thought both of you were really
well. Actually, I thought we were too, until Jake walked in on Gregory and me.
No,
you know Jake, quickest man alive to jump to conclusions.
But did he jump, or did you push him?
Oh, he was pushed all right, but not by me. And I tried very hard to explain, but it seems he already knew the whole sordid story.
How?
Guess.
Claire Howard?
Lucy Coe.
Well, hello. Nice to see you.
Madam.
Oh, thank you.
So did I meet Gordon Green, guys?
We are indeed. Well, at least it's different.
It was fun.
Right this way.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Oh, everything looks so wonderful.
Doesn't it? That was all Larry's idea. I didn't know a thing about it.
Yes, I realize it takes quite a stretch of the imagination to visualize the Quartermain mansion as a humble Greek fishing village. You could all indulge me.
Oh, sugar, hi there.
Charlene. Hi, cousin. Nice to see you. And Lady Ashton, happy birthday.
Thank you very much.
I can't tell you, this place looks so wonderful. I just love Greece. It's so romantic, isn't it?
Yeah, I guess it can be.
You know what I don't understand? Why it is, it must be the Mediterranean air. You know, you just can't control yourself. I think you take two people from anywhere in the world, complete strangers, and by the end of the week, they're acting like lovers, a honeymoon couple. I really think Greece is definitely for lovers.
So, Lucy, did you come here alone?
Not by design, Aunt Shirley.
What happened? You get stood up?
I got stood up by an escort who had to defer to the goddess Justice.
What?
Scott Baldwin was going to bring me here, and he got delayed at the courthouse. I guess the bizarre turn of events over there kept him from coming. I don't know when he's going to be here.
Come on, counselor.
Admit it. Scorpio, know your thunder.
Yeah. You gotta be disappointed at the outcome.
Why, justice was served.
Yeah, and you had your airtight case shoved back down your throat.
Yeah, you can put all the spit you want on what happened today, but the real Scooby-Dooby was that the cop upstaged you was supposed to be on your side. How do you feel about that?
With, a friend like Scorpio, who needs enemies.
Hey, you almost sound like you expected to lose the case. Surely you must be shocked.
I was a little surprised by this mystery suspect, but I'm just glad he showed up.
Oh, you were, huh? Mm-hmm.
Yes, otherwise an innocent woman could have gone to prison.
Yeah, an ambitious prosecutor might have made it straight to the DA's chair.
If not higher. Yeah.
My sole concern is the truth, contrary to public opinion. If I was just after my own well-being at the expense of the public, why haven't I filed additional charges against Anna Lavery, Cheryl Stansberry, and Julian Jerome?
That's my next question.
Yeah,
why haven't
too.
You?
I'm so glad you asked.
What kind of charges?
Well, for starters, let's see. Possession of a deadly weapon with intent to kill. I could come up with a couple more off the top of my head. But why make the taxpayers fork over more of their hard-earned money?
Spoken like a true politician.
Yeah. Hey, Counselor, the election was last month.
Yep, the best man won. Shows you the system works, and I'm damn proud to represent it.
There's Mrs. Lavery.
Hey,
Mrs. Lavery, come on. 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 Come
on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Jake Meyer asked me if I'd like to thank you for everything that you've done a little while ago. I said no. I'd wait for another opportunity. Well, after this last performance, I'd just like to say thank you.
General Hospital, brought to you by Colgate Tartar Control Mouthwash, the only mouthwash that helps stop tartar before it starts.
Okay, fellas, it's all right. Go have some donuts.
You all right?
Oh, 5 minutes in, I'll be perfectly all
now,
right.
Now, stop it.
I'm sorry. Look, I just do my job, nothing personal.
Of course not.
I'm sure if the tables were turned, you would have done the same thing.
To you? Yeah. Maybe I'll get the chance one day.
Come on, let's go. Have a good night.
Miss Wallman.
It's a phone call for you.
Oh, look, if it's the press, just tell them they can read about it in my upcoming novel.
No, I don't think so. It's some lady on the phone, and she didn't identify herself as being with the press. What's she want?
She just said she had to talk to you.
Thank you.
Hi, it's me.
How'd you find me?
I didn't find you. I've been looking all over for you.
Aren't you supposed to be over at the Quartermain party?
Scott, that's where I am. Now, aren't you supposed to be here with me?
I don't feel much like socializing.
Oh, yeah? Since when?
Since Scorpio made a fool out of me.
Well, I'm sorry to tell you, but facts are facts.
Yeah, well, the fact is I got laughed out of the courtroom, and I'm certainly not going to come over there and everybody just rub my face in it. So why are you so anxious for me to get over there anyway?
I you know what it is? I do not like going to parties alone. I guess I'm just a good old-fashioned girl. What is so funny?
The idea of you being an old-fashioned girl.
I am serious here. Would you please get over here right now?
Oh, come on, Lucy. Spit it out.
Spit out what?
The real reason why your Diana roped me into this party.
I just told you why.
No. You just said the first thing that popped into your head. I want to know what's really going on. Come on, I haven't got all night.
Well, excuse me for being very concerned about you.
That'll be the day.
I am serious. I was worried because I know how bad you feel about the trial, and I wanted to take your mind off of it. And I hate to see you just sitting around feeling sorry for yourself.
Lucy, you have a real way of arousing my curiosity.
So, what does that mean? Are you coming or not?
Yeah, I'll be there in a little while.
Good. You won't regret it. And neither will I.
Yes,
I think I want another one.
On the floor. One more time. I would like to propose a toast, ladies and gentlemen. A toast to Ariel, our birthday girl. Thank you very much for allowing us to share in the fun.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Oh, a surprise for you.
Why
don't you run in with her?
Oh, no.
Oh, well, why not? I said before, you're
wonderful.
Oh, remember?
No, Larry, people
don't look at me. I couldn't possibly keep up with
her. Colton, let's go. You go join her. Go on, do the honors.
Come on.
You'll encourage others.
I couldn't possibly. I'm hopeless.
Come on,
you can't disappoint your fans. Let's go. Get it, Father.
Thank you.
That was amazing. You obviously learned a great deal in Greece. I had no idea that you were there. When was that?
Oh, it was a long time ago.
Oh, really? Well, were you in Athens or the islands?
I was in Greece.
Right after you were discharged from the Marines. Isn't that what you told me?
Is it?
Yeah, he spent a few weeks traveling all over the country.
How do you know so much about it, darling?
We were discussing Greece on the yacht one day.
Oh, well, I wish you'd told me. I'd have been most interested.
I guess it just slipped my mind.
Well, if you'll excuse me.
Where are you going?
Just going out to get some fresh air.
I take it all back.
You take what all back?
All I said about this evening being a drag.
I hope it is late.
It's definitely starting to show some potential.
Excuse me, do you know something the rest of us don't know?
Only what I see.
Well, what I see is an overactive imagination at the moment.
Possibly. I'm going to need some more ouzo. Stuff seems to loosen more than tongues. Get you a glass?
Thank you, I'm loosened up.
Well, in that case. Glad there never any stables around when you need them.
Well, I know one of the
Hello, excuse me. I think we tend to get too settled in our ways. I think it's very important to just sort of shake things up once in a while. Well, especially when you get a little older.
Amanda, I couldn't agree with you more. You know, Claire, you certainly are shaking things up, so to speak, lately, huh?
No, to put it mildly.
Do you know, I really have wanted to ask you this. What's it like, truly, what's it like being the wife of a politician?
Nerve-wracking. Well, isn't it the same being married to any man?
Oh, well, yes, because she's living her private life in the public eye.
In the beginning, I was a little concerned about Gregory. He seemed so easily distracted. I thought that this job at the Capitol would keep him so busy he wouldn't have any time for any extracurricular activities.
Oh, well, that didn't work?
No, not initially. Of course, he did spend a good deal of time in Albany, but he kept making these little side trips back to Port Charles.
Oh, yes, and when you ask him about it, he made some flimsy little excuse that made it just sound plausible enough for you to give him the benefit of the doubt.
Oh, exactly. But then, out of the blue, Gregory seems to have become a devoted husband.
Oh, now you're in real trouble.
Well, Claire, what do you mean?
Well, in the car on the way over here this evening, all he could talk about was the new house that I just found for us in Albany.
Well, is that significant?
It's earth-shaking. Up until this evening, he'd never said a word about the place. But then, in the car, he actually asked me what sort of wallpaper I'd found for the master bathroom.
Uh-oh, call your lawyer fast.
Well, he said that he's intending to spend a great deal more time at home.
Oh.
Well, I was so stunned. I couldn't think of anything to say except why.
Oh, well, then what did he say?
Absolutely nothing. He just leaned over and
kissed me.
Oh, well,
what the world made him change his mind? I haven't the slightest idea, Amanda, and frankly, I could care less. I'm just so glad to have my husband all to myself again.
Oh, isn't that nice? I bet you are. Yes.